It's all pretty real now. Day has come. Off the airport. On the plane at 7 o'clock. No, you ain't coming, Bess. Sorry. You'll be alright. Hey, next time. Next time. Bloody shit hot. Pretty light flight.
30 seats.
Could have bought an extra bag. Oh, Wapiti Cafe. Always a good feed here. 10 days, is that all?
I don't think I'll be carrying this all up and down.
Aren't you going like 2 weeks?
Yeah,
oh, I'll be right. Here. That's all. I've just got a bit of dehyde to stick in the end. We'll be sweet. Box is empty. Oh, here we are, all loaded up. Probably should have got a bigger van. Couple ugly bastards in the back. Big grit, I don't know what he's grinning ugly. About. You got fucking 9 days of shit and bloody suffering. Time for a coffee and a pie. Oh, we just had to get out of the van, because that shit in there has dropped something disgusting. That needs a name, eh?
that moment where the chopper leaves you. 9 days. Okay. Well, that's me, the next 9 days. Pretty good campsite here. I was going to go further up this creek, but they suggested I come down here. A few more clearings to check out, and a few more open tops. I said to the pilot, didn't look that far from up there. He goes, yeah, not far up there in this. So we'll see what happens. Even if it takes me a couple of days, I'm going to have a go at getting up there. Why not? Where else would you rather be?
Well, finally got camp set up. Bloody good spot, actually. Sun's shining at the moment, but I'm prepared for the worst. Which invariably happens in Fiordland. So it looks like someone else has set up in here before, so no use trying to reinvent the wheel. Got a couple of big flies up there. Little two-man Freedom Atmos in there. Pretty waterproof by itself, but that'll just make the water run off a bit off the side. Big Stony Creek Vi up there, fly up there. In creek just through there, the old mount radio set up. We'll see if it's here tonight, but this is the best feature. Check that out for a view. Kia are scorching around the place, and kaka, plenty of tuis, crack of a day. But those tops, man. I'm going to try and get up there. Might have to take the tent and stay the night up there, I'd say, but it could be worth the effort. Big country. Real big country. It's a big clearing down here, so we'll load up and go down and check it out.
Wondering what I'm doing here. Aren't you, mate? What are you doing? Hey? Not scared at all, are you? Hey? How close are you going to get, mate?
A bit of a stakeout on the clearing this afternoon. A lot of sign around. A couple of noisy kias, that's about all. It's early days yet. It's only a bit after three. See what happens.
Oh, that's a nice freshly rubbed sapling. We might be in business here. A few good tracks around. Not a lot of animals, but that's really encouraging. It's made my afternoon, I tell you.
Alright. Day one, I suppose. Good night's sleep in their tent last night. No rain or anything, so not much of a test, but yeah, not too bad. Good little spot. Bacon, eggs, breakfast this morning. Get rid of the luxuries first. And might shoot up creek and see what's up there. Alright, see what happens.
Well, it's a pretty damp, miserable day. Not pissing down, really, but just really hard to find your way around this bush. It's if you find a good Wapiti trail, you're okay. But, yeah. But I'll tell you what, I've just heard a good roar just around the corner. So, yeah. If anything gives you a bit of encouragement, that's it. So, we'll cruise on around. She's pretty nasty, deep sort of bush. You see what I mean? It's just windfalls everywhere and wet and damp. And, yeah, it doesn't say, come on in. decent size old Wapiti track there. Probably just a hind, but or cow. If you say in Fiordland. But that's those Wapiti trails I'm looking for. Makes it a bit easier going. This big fella's up around the corner here somewhere, so see if we can catch up with him.
Well, no stag so far, but wouldn't mind catching up with the guy that dropped this. Probably dropped it 3 or 4 years ago. Be a lot bigger than that now. Anyway, she's a wet old day. Started off just a bit of a spit, so it's a bit steadier now, so I might head off back a couple of hours back to camp. A bit wet through at the moment, so luckily I've got some pretty good gear, so yeah, should be alright. Lunchtime soon.
Whoa, that feels better. The we've got a 3 or 4 hour walk around the up the end of the block. See how wet I can get. Saw a wicker and found a cast antler, that's about all I can see. There's a lot of fresh sign around, but yeah, I think that we lay low in this rain. I will be. Setup's working well. Double fly. The old tent in there. Absolutely hosing down at the moment. And possibly yet to get heavier, I'd say. It's raining like it does in Jordan.
So, once again, the old lime brown can comes in handy when it's pissing down outside and you need to get water. Let's make a bit of a funnel, tie it on the end of the tarp, and fill your bottle up. It's been going there for about 5 minutes now, and yeah, she's doing the trick. You saw it here first.
Well, time for a bit of light reading. See if I can learn something. Wouldn't mind being up there where it's not raining. Maybe a start. But I'll tell you one thing I haven't mentioned so far. Is bloody sandflies. Little bastards are everywhere. And just when you think you get away from them in your tent, they come inside your tent. And then you're sitting there thinking, oh, no, I've got away from them. And then they all sneak in, crawl down your legs and bite your face and your hands. And, man, shit, all the things. You can see a couple of buzzing around here now. There's something got to be done about them.
Well, this is one of the biggest slips that I've seen now so far. You see up there, that's where Bernard and Bridgie and Simon are. At the back of there somewhere. Sort of above where I was gonna land. They took me out of landing there and going downstream. Not sure that's a good idea or not, but early days yet. But the slip goes all the way up. It's been a bit of an event when it happened. Half the hill's come down. Yeah, she's a cracker. Hard to find words, really, this place. A lot different than the Yirrawarras. A lot different than the Kaimanawas. It's just really big, really tough. And it doesn't care. It just rains. A couple of days, 2 days. And if you don't like it, too bad. Whole place is just saturated. You can see where it's just been smashed year after year. How anything lives in here, I'm bugger do I know. But they do. Even the rivers are a different colour. Like a good cup of tea. Yeah, awesome place.
Well, welcome to Rob's Kitchen. Bit low on gas, although I don't know why I bother, because I just heard that I might have to fly out on Thursday because they're cancelling all the flights. But never mind. Bit of salami and onion in there. Uncle Ben's rice. Magic noodles. Voila. Can't wait to get into this. Well, looks like my little camp might be packed up sooner than I thought. Just got a message on the inReach that all flights are cancelled after Thursday. Today's Monday, so have a talk to the boys tonight and see what the decision is. No fearing crossings, they cancelled today. So yeah. What a bugger. Stay tuned. It's pretty dark now. If he doesn't come the next 5 minutes, then she's all over till tomorrow. It's good to hear him that roar, though. Man, he's got a bit of whop in him. A bit of snow up there. It's looking real cold. Got 2 pairs of socks on at the moment and my puffer jacket. Yeah. Sad to be leaving. No coronavirus in here. Spectacular.
She's all on this morning. There's a kaka just flying through. There's bloody Kia fighting with falcons. Weka's bitching and moaning in the bush. Bear to South Auckland. Well, those kids are tough. Boy, that falcon sorted them out.
Nothing else heard, so I'll just broadcast again. The message from the New Zealand government is, as of 12 o'clock tomorrow, only essential services will be operating, which
it's a different wicker.
He
must have given the other one a hiding.
And the whole country is going into level 4 alert.
You don't care, do you, mate?
So, if you want to get out, you have to get
Well, you're going to have a good feed out of me, mate. I've got heaps of tucker you can have.
Those radios standing by, just carry on. Standing by, and I'll go and do...
You're not scared at all, are you?
...and come back and contact you. I be based here now...
Oh, you want my gun?
Care,
might as well have it, mate. I've got no bloody use for it. You hungry, mate?
Where is the moment we needed the most? You kick up the leaves and the magic is lost. Tell me your blue skies fade to grey. Tell me your passion's gone. You had a bad day, you take it one down. You sing a sad song just to turn it around. You say you don't know, you tell me don't lie. You work at a smile and you go for a ride. You had a bad day, you count it, don't lie. You come back down and you really don't mind. You had a bad day, you had a bad day. And I don't need no care at all. You had a bad day, you take it one down. You sing a sad song just to turn it around. You say you don't know, you tell me don't lie. You work at a smile and you go for a ride. You had a bad day, you count it, don't lie. You come back down and you really don't mind. You had a bad day. Is lost. Cause you had a bad day, you take it one down. You sing a sad song just to turn it around. You say you don't know, you tell me don't lie. You work at a smile and you go for a ride. You had a bad day, you see what you like. And how does it feel? One more time. You had a bad day.
trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. Watch them grow, they're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
This ain't living, but we could run from Elysium and let it burn, let it burn. You've gotta know nothing lasts. Nothing new. And my lover's honesty, I can push it back down if I have to, if you want me to. 'Cause we can run now. What's left to lose if we
cast again in the corner, the back of the chop bar, camping by myself, and oldest in the group, but yeah, abandoned in the corner. You guys all comfortable over there? Yeah, no, all good.
No, no problem, Ross.
Happy years.